Welcome, everyone. My name is Sanne Kuipers, and I'm a PhD candidate from the Erasmus School of Health Policy and Management in Rotterdam, the Netherlands. I'm working on a project on patient-centered care in a primary care setting, and specifically for patients with multimorbidity. And today, I would like to present you the importance of patient-centered care and co-creation of care for satisfaction with care and physical and social well-being of patients with multimorbidity in the primary care setting. So let's start with an introduction of the multimorbidity patients. Multimorbidity is the presence of two or more chronic conditions in one patient. And the prevalence of multimorbidity has grown tremendously, and it's actually expected to increase even further in the near future. And this increase poses a challenge. This type of patient has complex care needs, and therefore it's often difficult and also costly to manage good healthcare. Healthcare professionals are currently working with single disease-oriented guidelines, and well, as you can imagine, it does not adequately fit the needs of the patient with multimorbidity in their combinations of complex care needs. So we can argue that current care delivery is not tailored to the needs of patients with multimorbidity. And that is a problem, since the burden of multimorbidity is often related to adverse outcomes, leading to a greater mortality risk and an increase of healthcare utilization and cost. And as a result, patients with multimorbidity report lower well-being, quality of life, and satisfaction with care. And within the coming 15 minutes, I would like to argue that making care more patient-centered may be the way forward. So what is patient-centered care? Patient-centered care is care that is respectful to and responsive to the individual patient preferences and their values and their needs, and ensuring that the patient values and needs guide all clinical decisions. There are eight dimensions of patient-centered care. So we start with the patient preferences, which is of course taking into account the patient preferences and values. The other dimension is information and education, and that is informing the patient on all aspects of his or her care. But you can imagine that this information should also be on all levels of the patient. So if you're low educated, you should get the right information to your education level. Coordination of care is how you coordinate care within your practice, so within the primary care practice. Emotional support, you can imagine that having multiple chronic conditions, it also has an influence on your emotional status. So offering the right support on the emotional level is important as well. Then we have physical comfort, that's all about the absence of pain. Involving family and friends is also very important. You're not on your own. Continuity and transition is really about how you coordinate the care with other healthcare providers outside your practice. Access to care is, care should be accessible to everyone. So that is from, on the one side that you can really access the building. So if you're in a wheelchair, you can access the building, but also that care is financially accessible. And a systematic review found that when organizations work more patient-centered, they also have more positive outcomes. So for example, a greater satisfaction with care, a greater job satisfaction among healthcare professionals, but also an increased quality of life and well-being for patients. However, most of these studies were only conducted in hospital settings, and they were not specifically targeted to patients with multimorbidity. In addition to the eight dimensions of patient-centered care that tell us how patient-centered organizations are, it's also very important to examine co-creation of care. This is based on the quality of relationships, and it is characterized by patient-centered communication and interaction. And this is also very important to improve outcomes. So co-creation of care is the establishment of productive interactions between patients and their healthcare professionals. Co-creation of care is especially important in situations with complex tasks, uncertainties, and time constraints. And in this sense, co-creation of care is potentially very valuable for patients with multimorbidity, since it is complex to manage care for this patient type. And there are often difficulties and uncertainties in finding the right type of care that is adequately responsive to their needs. And GPs often report that providing care to patients with multimorbidity is often time-consuming. So in this sense, co-creation of care is potentially valuable for providing good care to patients with multimorbidity. And that leads us to the study aim. What is the relation among patient-centered care, co-creation of care, satisfaction with care, and physical and social well-being of patients with multimorbidity in a primary care setting? We conducted a cross-sectional study among 8 primary care practices in Noord-Brabant, the Netherlands. All patients with 2 or more registered chronic conditions were eligible to participate. The questionnaires consisted of several validated instruments and were sent by mail. And in total, 216 patients filled out the questionnaire and consented to participate. And this led to a response rate of 55%, which is actually quite high given the vulnerable status of this patient population and compared to other studies. I have to say that the practices that were in the study were actually quite enthusiastic practices, and they are leading in their patient-centeredness compared to other practices in the Netherlands. So this table displays the background characteristics of the patient. And if you take a look at the red outlined boxes, you can see that it concerns a very vulnerable patient group. So the mean age was 74 years old, and almost 40% was low educated, which really means that they only have a primary school and no further education. And 43% was single, which only adds up to the vulnerable status. The average evaluation of the patient-centered care of these primary care practices is 3.84 out of 5, which actually means that these practices are performing pretty well on patient-centered care. But there are two dimensions which score lower compared to the others, and that is emotional support and family and friends. And if you look at the lower red box, you can see that patients with multimorbidity often evaluate their relationship with their GP as higher compared to the specialist and nurse practitioner. Here you can see the results of the multivariate analysis. So after controlling for background characteristics, patient-centered care was associated with satisfaction with care, social well-being, and physical well-being. And co-creation of care was associated with social well-being and satisfaction with care. And although we found a significant association in the bivariate analysis between co-creation of care and physical well-being, this effect dissipated in the multivariate analysis. But as you can imagine, if you are in pain or your physical comfort is low because of the multiple diseases, you can imagine that when you have a very good relationship with, for example, your GP, that, well, maybe helps for your social well-being, but not it cannot take away the pain, so it doesn't add anything above the And why we choose this in primary care, because I think that's very important for patients with multimorbidity. They often see their nurse practitioner and general practitioner. And that's also, yeah, I think a lot of studies were already conducted in, well, hospital settings, and this was missing. And I think actually it's a very important next step. So that's why we choose for the primary care.
Answered. Any other questions? Yep. Just wait for the microphone.
Hello. Thank you. I'm Günter Danis from the Flemish General Practitioners, Belgium. Thank you for presentation. Co-creation is about two parties. You've got patients, patient-centered, but also professional caregivers. And in patient-centered care and co-creation, they both have to have satisfaction. Do you also measure the satisfaction of the professional caregivers, the doctors and the nurses and the physiotherapists in all those situations?
Yes, we did. We also have the data of the same questions, the same questionnaires among the healthcare professionals, but we have not analyzed them yet. So that's for next time, but yeah, we did.
Yeah, so you'll have to come back next year. Okay, great. Well, thank you again. That was an excellent start today. Thank you very much.
Thank you.